What's up, guys? This is the host. You're watching The Gray Medium, and today we're discussing a perfect union of contrary things. So first things first, let's take a look at some of my favorite quotes from the book. So the first quote that really jumped off the page to me was on page 19. Quote, Paul showed me that there's a difference between following the road and following the map. He taught me that when you focus on the teller of the tale or the hand pointing to an idea, you miss the whole point. End quote. The next quote that really stood out to me was on page 84. Quote, the ultimate goal, Campbell insisted, was not to discover the meaning of life, but the experience of life, to listen to one's heart and to fearlessly follow one's passion. On page 154, you read about a conversation between Lou Maglia and Maynard James Keenan, in which Maglia says, you can't keep building two-legged tables and bitch about them not standing up. 8 pages later, on 162, we hear Maynard talk about his relationship with Bill Hicks. Maynard states, if you lift the veil, you start to recognize that light is love, is infinite, is unconditional. Bill was saying that once you understand the nature of nature, you can let go of difficulties and sign on for the ride, knowing that it's just a ride. I found that the overall message I got from reading this biography was really just to have a diverse life experience. We see that Maynard goes from growing up in Ohio and eventually Michigan to then joining the army, where he moves around a bunch, then going to art school, dropping out of art school, and then pursuing a job in Grand Rapids, and then working in a pet store in New York, and then moving to LA. This guy moved around a ton, and because he moved around a ton, he had a lot of different diverse life experiences. He met different people, he was exposed to different art forms, and that helped him cultivate the creativity that translated into his work. So I feel like what I really took from reading this man's story was the fact that you have to try new things, you have to put yourself in uncomfortable positions, and you have to expose yourself to different art forms and different people in order to really bring the most out of yourself.
Okay, enough reading. Great book, but it's time to take a brain break. Gonna hit some training real quick, listening to some Tool music, of course. Today we're hitting some chest and tries, mainly with the rings, and we even got the Fear Inoculum merch on, so gonna go hit a lift real quick to get this brain break going. I'll be right back.
While the training footage rolls, I want to show you guys a quote that I read on page 255. Maynard states, a long time ago, people understood that the only thing that kept them alive was coordinating in groups and being more creative than the creatures that were threatening them. They were never going to be stronger or faster than those creatures, so they had to be smarter. We're losing touch with that because everything we need is readily available. You can't walk 10 feet in any direction without running into food, shelter, or clothing. I feel like art has taken a back seat. The whole creative process seems kind of odd because we don't think it's relevant to keeping us alive. But we need to use every fiber of our imagination, every spark of our creative energy, to stay ahead of what's happening to our planet, to our relationships, to our ability to think for ourselves. Life is too short not to create something with every breath we draw. I really feel like that quote, along with this book as a whole, really encapsulates what The Gray Medium stands for. Obviously, with this book, we're reading about how Maynard balances a perfect union of contrary things, similar to how The Gray Medium is solely based around balancing the mind and the body. I stress the importance of not only going to the gym to grow your muscles, but also going to the library to grow your mind. I find that Maynard's explanation of this is pretty interesting in this book. Early on, we hear about how he ran cross country and how he wrestled in high school, learning lessons that he would then apply to other circumstances throughout the rest of his life. He stresses the importance of this physical art form so much that he eventually goes on to pick up Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, installing wrestling mats above the loft that Tool rehearses in, and eventually even bringing his Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu coach with him on the road on Tool tours, that way he could keep rolling and grappling year-round. By expressing our art physically through our training, I feel like it helps us get our creative process going and continue to express ourselves in as many forms as possible. Hence the reason why I feel like this book is something that I really needed to talk about in the gym. One part of the book that also really stood out to me that I'd like to demonstrate real quick is an example that one of Maynard's school teachers gave him. He explained the importance of having a strong network, and he explained this using books. He puts one book standing straight up on a table and places another book balancing across the top of it. As he soon demonstrates, the students recognize that this book doesn't have a stable foundation. Shortly after, he then stacks that same book on top of two books that are standing horizontally, and that book has a slightly more stable foundation. And then the teacher progressively shows how the more books that this top book is laying across, the stronger the foundation it has and the less likely it is to fall over. This analogy obviously shows us that it's important to have a variety of different people you can depend on. If all you trust is put in one person, you're more likely to fail. But like the book that has multiple books to stand on, if you have multiple people to rely on, then you're more likely to succeed. I could go on for hours about why I love this book, but I decided to keep it short and simple for today. Nonetheless, I hope this video inspired you to go do something creative, the same way that this book did for me. Until next time, this is the host, you're watching The Gray Medium, stay gray.